Hi everybody, this is Al Spath. It's the day after Thanksgiving here in the US of A. It's the 27th of November, and I'm on here with Rondster. Hi, Rondster.
Hey, good morning everybody. Happy Thanksgiving.
This is Rondster's second session of his holiday package that he purchased from me, and the first one he played at the 50 cent table, and he was a $33 winner during that session, which is very good. Today he's having problems getting on full flush poker, and we're waiting for the support team to help. So what we're going to do here today is, this is myself here sitting at the table, teach. I've got a king four of spades. Rondster's going to make all, he's going to do all, everything. He's going to make the decision on how much to bet. I'll do it and everything, exactly what he wants. Okay, Rondster, it's to you. And somebody just called from the small blind. Are you watching the table, Ron?
I don't have the table up here. How are you supposed to get the table up?
Well, I'll tell you what I'll do. I have to share my screen with you. That's what we're gonna have to do. I didn't do that, and so it automatically checked. So we're checked. We have King Four, and you should be able to see me now on your Skype.
I do. Okay, so
he checked the flop, and it's to you.
Okay, so we got a pair of fours. He's checked. He's showing weakness. I'm going to put in a three-quarter bet here. And see how he responds. Okay, he calls, and our 10 comes out. Let's see if he checks here.
What's the plan if he checks?
Well, if he checks again, it's either I got to put in a decent-sized bet, or he's just, you know, rolling us with like a pair of sixes or a pair of eights. So that's the question, and so we have to find out where we are. Let's put in $1.25 bet. Now we'll know exactly, because if he calls here, we know that we're beat, and unless we luck out. I'm hoping this is a high enough bet that will show us either way. We got to get some information. It's a little late to get the information, but okay, we got the fold.
Okay, let me tell everybody that's listening in today, and I'll repeat it later on. As you can see, we're in a small blind with pocket deuces, red. Rondster, any money that I win, since Rondster's making all the decisions, Rondster gets to keep. If anything I lose, Rondster gets to pay me back. What do you want to do?
Well, here with a pair of twos. Okay, well, we're going to put a pot size bet in.
Pot size is 50 cents.
Right.
Okay. Remember, when you're in a small blind and you hit the pot size bet, you really are doing a min raise.
That's correct.
So, okay, just so those out there that know, when you're out of position, you want to go a little bit more than a min raise. You want to always go a little bit more. If you're under the gun, you always want to go a little bit more than if you're in late position on a raise, because you're out of position.
Right. Exactly. And I should have gone a little more, but we got away with it. Here we're gonna put a dollar bet in.
$1, he says. Okay, a pot size bet would have been 60 cents. Rondster's decided to go a dollar, which is more, and he has position, and he gets a call from the blind.
So here we have an open-end straight. He checked very fast. I'm not sure whether he is trying to pull something or not. We're going to do $2 for information on this.
$2.
He either has it, or he called, so he's looking for it. We have the straight, and so now we're going to see what he does. All right. So he's saying that he doesn't have it, but he's calling us, so he's still trying for it. So we're going to put in a $6 bet. We're going to make him pay if he's drawing, and that's the big thing here. I want to make him pay if he's drawing. Okay.
Yeah. Now, how would I have played that? When he checked the flop, I might have taken a stab like you on some occasions, depending on the opponent. And sometimes I would take a free card because I have the open end, and then see if a heart came out on the turn before I did anything. But go ahead here. You got.
We're gonna put a $1 bet in.
Okay, so you're sticking to the $1 bets. That's okay. I just seeing what you're doing here and checking it out.
We have position, which is what I like. He's checking. We need information. We're going to put a pot-sized bet in.
Didn't mean to put that over the pot. I was just dragging my cursor down. I wasn't trying to tell you what to do. You decide. It's all on you.
I would have done that anyway.
This one? Ron? Rodster? Hello, Ron. I'm going to fold the 7-10 for him. I don't know where he's at. Oh, I think the Skype is just making a bad connection at this time, folks. He'll be back in just a second. Ron?
Yeah, I'm here.
Okay, yeah, well, the Skype was giving us problems, and I just assumed that this 10-7 you were folding.
I was.
Okay.
We're not going to be playing any 10-7s too soon.
Too soon? When would you ever play 10-7?
There might be a situation where I might be on the button. Uh-huh. You know, and something is working in my favor, but you know, I don't usually play 10-7, so, but it's more of a tournament play if it's a button move or something like that.
Correct.
Not a cash play.
When you're not in the hand, are you busy watching the other people and looking at the board and trying to put what they're on? And go ahead.
Yeah, I mean, look, for everybody that's listening out there, this is very, very important, especially when
you're... Well, you got to bet. You got to do something here.
But I can't because I don't have the screen share yet.
Oh, God. Okay.
I'm so sorry.
You got to tell me that, man.
I didn't know. I thought you knew.
No. I can't tell that. When you fell off, that's what was to happen. Okay. You're back.
Okay.
You raised the pot under the gun with ace-8 in a six-player thing, and you won.
Okay, great.
So it didn't cost you any money.
That's fine. So for everybody that's listening out there, watching when you're not playing is one of the most important tools you could possibly ever have. You want to know who's loose, who's tight, what range of hands they're playing, and this helps you to do it. So if you're not playing because you're not getting cards or whatever the thing is, hold on one second. We got an A5 of diamonds. I'm going to fold it out. Okay, so it's really important to take advantage of that time and seeing how everybody's playing so you can get that edge.
Every edge you get adds up, and the more edges you get, now you have A7 here and you're in small blind when you got a min raise and two callers.
Yeah, I mean, they're showing a lot of weakness out there, okay, and so what we're going to do here, we're going to pot it. We'll see who's strong and who's not strong right now. We'll get some information. That's a lot of weakness out there. Okay, we get a call. And we're out of position here. So we still need to get some direction here. So we're going to bet.
Hurry up.
$5. And see if Duplass has got it.
I would have noticed that this guy called you. He min raised and he called you immediately. I thought he had an overpair to this board, and I think that you're
folding here.
Toast now. But he told me exactly what I wanted to know. I in fact, I would have folded the A7. I wouldn't have, with that many people there out of position with A7, I wouldn't even try to steal it. That's me. But I just wanted everybody to know out there, everybody takes a different way. If you're gonna play it, you gotta play it like Rondster played it. But if you don't play it, you probably save more money in the long run because the cards are not strong and you're out of, you know, position.
We're going to fold off this jack. So
does that make sense, Ron?
Yeah, it sure does.
Four-handed.
Okay, so a four-handed, a king four has a lot more value, and so we're going to put that 75-cent bet in.
So he's going again, more than the pot size bet. Pot size would have been 60 cents. Quick call again from Duplace.
Okay, but this time we have the position on him. Interesting that he made a quick call. We don't know exactly where we are. We're going to put a bet of $2 in here. try to get that information.
The thing to note for everybody is that Rondster has a four, and if a king comes off, he's got two pair, four comes off, he's pretty golden there. But the 10 jack is out there, very dangerous cards to be up against.
Yep, but I needed the information to know if he had it. A5, I'm folding out.
So, Ron, you were up around $30, and then you went on an adventure because you had the A7. A lot of times, if I'm running good and I'm plus money and stuff like, and I'm out of position like that, I just say to myself, look, I've been pretty active. I've been getting away with some things. This is one where, you know, one guy min raise, a lot of guys down at this level, not just for weakness that min raise. Sometimes they do it to set it up because they want to have a race, or they want somebody to come over the top of them, or they want them to interpret its weakness. And there's so many situations there that one of those guys was going to stay and give me trouble, and I still got A7 out of position. I just let that go. I just don't get involved in that hand.
Right. Okay, so we have one caller, 25 cents. We're gonna raise it up a dollar.
Out of position.
But he was weak. He showed weakness, and that's why I did it.
Did he post, or did he really limp?
Let me see. He might have posted.
Okay.
I might have missed that one. I'm gonna check out of that one.
Okay. Let me see the note I got on Hot Dog here. It says he slow played kings all the way too long. He took kings all the way to the river, slow playing it all the way. So.
I'm gonna pull that out. Over on the button.
We don't see anybody that's in the chat room at this time to answer any questions from. Can you quickly check your email and see if you got a notice that I went live?
Sure. Hold on.
Just want to make sure that went out. You got Queen Jack in the middle position.
Yeah, hold on a second. Let me go here. Okay, we're gonna raise that up to $1.50.
Quick call from Duplis.
Yep, I see that.
So we always, when somebody does that, we know they got probably either a decent ace. They don't have a strong ace because they usually come over the top, or they have a pair.
So another question is, he's checked to see if I'm going to bet. I'm going to check. I take a free call.
I would have fired there. I would have fired the continuation three-quarter bet.
Okay. Well, we're gonna do that right now. We're gonna fire a $4 bet.
$4. Okay. So you put yourself in jeopardy betting there, because the fact that you give three cards that are in the playing zone, the nine, that the queen, and you know, it just makes it harder for you to get people out, because right, they may have a gut shot, or they may have an open-ended straight draw.
I'm gonna fold that 10-4 out.
Okay.
I should have barreled again, and that side of me that says, you know, well, let's see what happens in the next card.
Well, it's not that side of you. It's what you got. You know, the guy kept coming at you earlier, and that's why you decided in your subconscious, hey, I know it's not going to work, why am I going to put money in here, or something like that. So sometimes you have to do it, not because this guy over here did it, okay, but because this guy here was in. So even if you don't get him out, you got to get him out. You
yes.
understand? That's why you needed to reduce the field down so that you could win on the turn. As it turned out, you won anyhow because you hit one of your cards on the turn and it didn't help them. But if it would have hit them, you know, things would have been different. Oh, Soft Top is in. Nigel's in from the UK. So that's good to know that we are.
I didn't see that. I didn't see you in my email for whatever reason.
Okay.
Maybe missed it or something. I don't know.
Well, I posted it.
Okay,
get ready. You think about what you're going to do.
Well, I mean, we only got one player. It's 50 cents in the pot. I've got a good hand. Let's make it a dollar.
Right, because you know you don't want to give him a free shot at it for 15 cents. Make him pay 75. He's out of position. If he folds, You take down the money. It's absolutely. You've got to pay for your blind somehow, and that's one way of doing it.
Right. Now we have a queen nine, but we're out of position. I'm going to fold out.
Okay. Against this opponent here, you got to find out what he's going to do. He's folded twice to you. You got to take his money until he starts to defend. Okay.
Right.
I've noticed that he's not defending, so you've got to make that notice too.
Okay. Well, I'm going to fold queen four out on the button.
Now, see if this guy raises. See if he defends. Just get an indication of. Okay, here we go. Now he defended. So now we say he's got a better hand in this situation. All right.
Right.
Because he defended. Now I think he'll bet this one. Nope, he didn't again. He's staying now. Remember, he's the guy with kings that slow played him to the end. He had A7, which is a decent hand. He should have raised with A7 first, not called his raise.
Exactly.
So he made the big mistake. So we examine everybody's play.
We're going to fold out here.
For those watching and those listening on the video, there was no 25 cent, 50 cent games going. We'd go to a higher table, but there wasn't any this morning, so we chose this one over the 10 player table so we can get more hands in to demonstrate what Rondster's trying to do. And of course, sat with the $25. I'm Rondster today. He's making all the decisions here. His software is not working. He can't get on the system for some reason. Hopefully that'll get that cleared up. But he's making all the decisions. If he wins, then I owe him the money that were plus 25. And if he loses, then he owes me the money that were negative. So it's all his decisions. And we're going to get his analysis. And then I'll give you mine afterwards and tell you what I would have done in certain situations, just to see if there are any differences.
Okay, so we have a queen 10, 50 hand, I mean, it's six-handed. Yeah, Duplessis is sitting out, so that's five. You know what, with him sitting out, let's put a dollar into this.
Right, you always got to be aware of how many hands that you're playing.
I'm at ace out there, he's checking. I'm going to say, I want to know where I am, so I'm going to put out a $2 bet. If he has the ace, he's going to come over, he's calling, let's see if he's checking this down. Now, the question is he leading me on or not, because I'm not getting any information. I'm going to check.
Okay, if he called you immediately when you bet, there's no draws out there for hearts or diamonds or anything, so I'll leave it to you to distinguish what he must have.
I'm definitely, based on his history, I'm folding out.
Right. He has to have the ace. He's not going to stay. If there's an ace staring him in the face, there's no draws out there. I mean, sure, he could have trip fives or trip nines, but even if he has the ace, he's got you beat. As soon as he stays, you know, you don't improve. You got to say, that's it. You know, you made your stab. You don't need to compound it.
Exactly. I'm folding out here at 9-5.
That's why we bet when we read heads up, to find out what, not only to take it down, not only to put more money in the pot, but we need to tell the person that we've got a strong hand. And if we tell them they have a strong hand and they stay or they come back over the top of us, we have to make note of that fact. We can't just assume that they're on a draw when the board is drawless. That was a 5-9 ace flop. And I mean, the only draws would be if they had like 7-8 and a gut shot or something like, you know, 6-7. With a gut shot, things like that, or you know, 2-3, 2-4, you know, something like that.
We're gonna fold out here.
Right. So, the texture of the flop is very important. It's critical to making your decisions. And if you're not looking at that, and you're not looking at how many people are in the hand and how much money each person has and what their tendencies have been, you know, whether they defend or if they're how fast. You know, speed means everything in this game online. To me, I can tell a lot from speed because people get into patterns when they do have a hand or when they don't have a hand. It's more difficult for us right now because we can't use speed because Rondster's doing analysis and then he's telling me, you know, what to do and stuff. So we're at a little disadvantage. So Soft Top came in. He got an email apparently, because he or he read one of my Facebook. I'll wait and see what he responds in chat. There is a delay. What are you going to do here?
Good question. I mean, 7-6 off. I have a diva button. I have position. I'm just going to fold it up.
Okay. I would pot it here, okay? I would pot it because it's not bad. Just because it's 7-6 offsuit, it's a 3% difference in suited. But because I had the position there, I would have probably potted it here. He would have maybe called, and then he would have checked. I would have taken the free card there. Then, see, he checked again, and I probably got another free card out of it. And then I made him straight.
Ooh, look at that.
So that's the difference. See? See how ace, queen, big hand, didn't bet it all the way. See that?
Right.
That's just like the kings, didn't bet it. So that my note on him is
Gonna
correct.
pull this out now.
So do you understand what I'm saying there with the 7-6 run?
Yeah, I do.
Because there's an opportunity to steal the blinds, and even if you don't steal the blinds, you know, you're in position, you're gonna get either a free card or you're gonna, you know, continuation bet and win the hand. And if you continuation bet, you're gonna get a free card on the turn. You're gonna take the free card on the turn because you have a gut shot, and then you're gonna just win on the river because you're gonna hit your card. Although there was three spades, you're still
Right.
gonna win. So just when you play this back and you watch it, see the little nuances that you're not maybe thinking about or how you could play it. Just be aware.
Fold this out.
You understand? I'm not saying that's the way to play it. I'm saying that's the way I would have played it, and you should be. It's not that you need to play it that way. Those are the either listening or Ronster. It's that you need to know what your options are, so that sometimes you do it, sometimes you don't. But if you do it, this is how you do it.
Okay, I'm also going to fold out this ace three. Yeah, I mean, I've done it that way before too. So I've done it both ways, and I just had decided for whatever reason, didn't feel like doing it, and I let it fly. But it would have worked out really well. So queen 10 suited. You know what? I'm also going to let that fly.
You're not going to call us 25 cents. Okay? You're
Not gonna.
folding, right?
I don't want to get in trouble because I'm out of position and
There's
something could.
no way I fold there for 25. What I was going to tell you is I wouldn't come over the top because the last time he did 50 cents like that, you know, he wanted action. All right? So I would have called him. I would have seen the flop with the queen 10 because he's got $25 there that I can double up on.
Okay, so 75 cent more here.
And what does Hot Dog do in retaliation? He's calling.
All right, so he's calling, and we got a jack out there. Let's pot it.
Thank you, Nigel. I'm sure he got a notification on from his mobile device.
So now he's called us twice, and his history is that every time he does that, he has something he's slow playing down to the river. I'm going to check the turn.
Okay, what do you think he has?
I think he might have a jack.
I agree.
So, I'm also going to check it down here also.
He's
Hopefully
gonna
the
check it back. Oh, I thought he had the jack as well. He didn't have anything.
Wow, he fooled us.
You could have got value from him.
Well, yeah, I know. Kind of hard to get value without him, but.
Well, you said it yourself. He's a calling station.
Yeah, he is. Well, we're gonna note that for the future, though. I mean, we got a little time on our hands. Yeah, here we're on the button with a 10-8. Okay, we're gonna pop that.
That's right. You're not getting. You don't have to do a dollar to do the, to get the same effects you normally would.
So now here we want to figure out how to get money out of this guy, and so forth. So I would say 60 cents.
You're gonna go 60 cents, 65 or 60? Which
That's,
one?
yeah, 65 is fine.
Okay. I would have checked it.
We got a call, which is nice. Now it's a potential, possibly he has aces. So since he's calling, let's do a dollar and see if we can suck him some more.
Gonna let this time run down a little bit here just to make him think that it's. You're not knowing what to do and you're stealing.
All right, now I gotta make a decision. Do we go all in or do we just raise?
Yeah.
I say let's go max. If he's got anything at all, he's gonna call.
I would have went $10 and kept him in it.
Yeah. Let's see if he calls. He might have aces over. And if that's the case, oh, yeah, so I did wrong. Okay.
I don't know if you did wrong or not, but I would have kept him in there. That even if he has an eight, I just still think you're in pretty good shape.
I'm gonna fold out this queen three. I should have done a little less. I keep thinking that I might be able to trap some of these guys and take them, you know?
I did the same thing last week. I had kings twice, and I went all in, and I tried to get them to come at me, and they wouldn't come at me, and I lost some value on it, so.
Okay, so what we're gonna do here, we're gonna raise it up 50 cents, min raise.
Just a min raise.
Yeah, wanna keep him in. And if I boo-boo, then I boo-boo. Let's see if he's gonna do anything with that. Let's go 50 cents more. Just enough, hopefully, to keep him in. And let's do $1. And let's do $3.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. He's going to bet into you.
Oh, we gotta wait. I don't think he's gonna bet into me, but if he does, he does. Yeah, I'm sure he'll check it down. Oh, he did. Let's make the call in case he has an eight.
Let him stay there a long time. You let him put money in, you won that thing, but I think your betting was a little bit low. I know what you were doing, and you were trying to bring him along, but I think you needed to make it just a tad bigger, okay?
Okay.
Tad bigger.
Well noted.
Don't give him minimum. Don't give him decent odds. You want to keep him in, but you want to give him marginal odds to come in, not good odds.
Okay, we're going to do $1 here.
What? He
One.
raised, and you're going to go $1 here?
I'm sorry, hold on.
I'm
Yep,
sorry.
my fault. I didn't. I have to watch better. I'm folding up.
Okay, I just wanted to make sure because you were talking. You can do
Yep.
anything you want. I just wanted to make sure that you. I think your mindset is 25-50, so you're seeing 50, and you're thinking it's a limp.
Yep.
I think that's the problem.
Exactly correct.
Hey Nigel, Soft Top 666 is in chat. If there's anything that any of my videos that I've been putting out, and any of you that I'm not covering, any subject, or you got any questions, or something you want me to go over, or you want me to go in more depth of, or something I missed completely. Email me alspath@alspath.com, and I'll be happy to work on that for you. And Nigel, since you're in chat, just put something in chat if there's anything that comes to mind, or hopefully you've been watching. And now, Ron.
Okay, I'm gonna take this 10-7. I'm gonna fold it out.
Well, you said maybe later you were gonna play. Oh, I'm just kidding you.
Oh
I'm just kidding
yeah. There are circumstances. Now,
I
listen,
remember. I
River
remember
Pro should
those.
be.
Go ahead.
You have any notes on River Pro?
I don't have anything on Durapo. Excuse me, my wife. She's on and off the phone like QVC this morning. That's her Black Friday. She's on the phone, dialing them up. Uh-oh, big bet here. Takes it down. For those that are watching, I'm Al Spath. I'm your instructor for today. I'm here with Rondster. We're at Full Flesh Poker. Rondster's software is not working today, so I'm allowing him to play my hand. He's got 9-2. It's up to him on every decision he makes.
Okay, we're gonna fold that out.
Okay. If he loses, he owes me the money. If he wins, I owe him the money. It's as simple as that. He's got to make all the decisions he wants to make at this table. If you're following me up at Twitch, I appreciate that. Hit the red heart. It's Al Spath, one word, SPATH. And if you follow me up at YouTube, it's Al Spath, two words. You subscribe there and it's free. I appreciate it. I got over 100 videos there on how to build a bankroll at the micro limits, and then finally how to escape the micro limits.
I wonder why I don't have that it didn't come up on my email. That doesn't make any
I don't know.
sense.
Twitch is finicky sometimes.
Okay.
And now?
I'm sorry, I was looking for an email. Yeah, we're folding 10.
Go ahead and see if it's there now. It may sometimes be a delayed action. I don't know, but I...
No, it hasn't come out.
It's strange.
Yep.
I'm not getting pinged by anybody else on Skype. Nigel's more of a SNG, a tournament player. But this last week, I think I put two sit-and-goes up for you, Nigel. I don't know if you saw the one with Matthias Anderson, the guy from Poker School Online. Here you go. Got a good hand?
We're going to raise it up to $1.25.
That's right. He's out of position. He wants to charge him a little bit more. So if Duplis or Hot Dog wants to come in with their calling station, they're going to pay a little bit more. This makes up for the times you're going to lose these hands. Oh, he got three callers and no face cards.
So we have three callers, a crummy flop. We're going to have to bet $5.
He's going to go five. Why wouldn't you go the whole pot then if it's 525?
No, I just, that's what came to mind.
I know, I just, quick.
That's a quick call.
You need a spade or a king or an ace here, don't you?
Spade. Okay, so he fast call. I'm going to check.
Okay, but I'm going to check here. Ronson's not going to change his mind, but I want everybody to know what this guy's got, what the pot is, all right? What is he left to do here?
He's got a bet.
What is he going to bet?
The whole thing, probably. Let's see if he does.
Unless he thinks you got a queen here.
We're going to call.
No hesitation. Calling, fake, calling $5 for 19. You get 4-1 on your money, and you've got 18% to win, right?
Right.
And possibly a little more if you get an overcard, but you don't know.
There it is. Okay, so we're going to put him in, all in.
That's what you want to do, huh?
Yep. Let's see if I lose him or not. Yep, I got him.
Only a two. Only a two. Oh, Nigel said he did get to watch the one with Matthias from the 2004 final table at the World Series of Poker. That's great. And he did get to watch the other one I did the other day at, I think it was playing tight out here. We've got a raise here from River Pro, and I don't have a note on him.
I do. He's wide and loose. We're going to call.
Okay. I don't care if he's wide and loose. If I'm out of position with these cards, I got to think that he's got either a pair or an ace, and I'm a real underdog and I'm out of position. I would have... Oh, you said call. Oh, shoot. I'm sorry.
Yeah, that's okay.
That's my bad. I would have folded that in a heartbeat, but I did it anyhow. Shoot.
Sometimes, if I'm way ahead in money, it may not be the right thing, but if I'm way ahead in money, I will sometimes take a flyer.
I'm going to tell you about that way ahead in money in just a second. Go ahead. What do you want to do here?
All right. So we got a 9-7. We got Hot Dog. We're out of position. I'm folding up.
Wow.
I don't know.
That's a great hand. That's the hand that makes you. That's the hand with a 10-8 or an 8-6 flop, that, or 2-7s or a 9-7. That's the hand that makes you the most money at these low games. That's a leak, Rondster.
Okay.
That's a big leak. That was a big hand here.
Well, we're gonna bet a dollar here.
Okay, but I'm pointing those out. Those that are watching us, not to embarrass Rondster. He wants to learn. He wants to know that kind of stuff. But those are the hands that you gotta not throw away. Those are dynamite hands. Those are the ones that wins. The ace kings and ace queens rarely hold up. And like as you've seen, Ronson didn't hit nothing with his ace king there. He finally got a flush, but that was a backdoor lucky flush.
We're going to bet $1.25 here.
See, now Ronson is what we call opening his game, and his range is up here. And I think this is a mistake on Ronson's part and a lot of people's part. They get reverse tilt. This is reverse tilt, folks. You start getting a euphoria about how you're doing and you're controlling the table, and then you start betting like this, and you're going to get targeted real fast, and you're going to be open range, missing everything.
Okay, well, we're going to check it.
No, do what you would do. I mean, that's what you would do?
Yeah, we'll check it.
Not because of what I said. I'm just saying, it's just, you get yourself in a situation where you don't have to give money back to the table, and you leak off some of the money that you've already gained, and it's just, in my opinion, foolish.
We're going to fold.
You know, it's there's no reason to get involved with that king nine there. It's just, unless you really get lucky, unless you really love that hand for some reason, it's just a killer.
Okay. Let's do this. Let's play this 6-5. Let's raise it a dollar.
Okay, everybody together that's watching now, you heard my comment last hand. Say it together. Rondster still reverse tilted. This is not a playable hand under the gun. Now he has to play it.
Let's do $1.50.
$1.50 against the calling station.
He should fold.
Yep. So he won. He had a continuation bet. Everybody out there that's listening understands that part. But I still think that some of these hands that Rondster may be doing right now is he's in that state that he's running good and he wants to continue it. And you're trying to press the issue. And I think you all have to just think about that when you're playing.
So we are in the big blinds and... Well, now I'm really confusing myself. Let's just check it down.
No, that's a good play from there. They're all targeting you right now. You're the table monster, okay? Rondster the monster. They're thinking that, you know, you're going to do something, so they're going to sit back and try to trap you.
Well, let's do a dollar here.
Wow, this is a very wet board, 2, 3, 4. You got sets. You've got a five... pocket fives out there, you got overpairs to the board. This is a play again I would not try here. I would have given up on this hand and hoped that they checked it back and I got a spade on the turn. And myself.
Yeah.
This is a dangerous play here, folks.
Reports in her hands and or you know, they're always a possible ace. Okay. This is what he does a lot. I am definitely gonna check out here. He gave us the information. If I don't use the information, I'm stupid. So if I'm going for information, I might as well use it.
But again, I would have not even, you know, I wouldn't have done it. I wouldn't have played it. I just, nothing.
Okay.
I would have just checked it.
I agree. So let's fold out of here.
Okay. And again, Ron said, I'm not trying to discourage what you're doing. You're winning. You're doing fine, okay? I'm trying to tell everybody else that's watching, and for you, when you watch it back, I think when you see it in slow motion, kind of when you're not under the gun to make a decision, you're going to say, man, I am kind of going the other way. All of a sudden, I'm playing hands that I would throw in the trash all day long, and I'm trying to make something happen because I think I got these fools dominated.
Yeah, well, I'm not really thinking that way, but my subconscious might be acting that way. But
yeah, that's another way of putting it.
Okay, so we have a king three on the button. We have 1, 2, 3, 4 players. Let's see what TJ's going to do. If he folds, we're going to bet a dollar.
Okay, you're getting comments from the chat room that say, slow down, Rondster.
I see that. But forehand to king three.
No, they're not talking about that. Remember, they're a minute and a half behind. They're talking about the other two hands.
Oh, okay. Gotcha. So A7, again, it's forehanded. If I'm going to play, I either got to bet, so I'm going to bet a dollar.
It's not taken. Oh, there it is.
It's either, you know, bet or fold because I can't limp in. So now, River Pro, if I bet here, I'm in a little bit of a quandary because I know he's going to come over the top of me because that queen is out there. But I have to find out where I am. So I'm going to bet $2.
I would have went for a check raise.
Okay, that's interesting to know.
I would have given him the opportunity to bluff at, and then I would have come over the top like I had the queen.
Right, so, exactly. Well, let's see what he
Because
does.
You raised pre-flop.
Yeah, I did. So let's see if we can make him fold, or is he going to do a last-second pop?
Yeah, see, he's gone. He went away. So if you would have checked there, he might have checked, or he's timed out or whatever. But if he would have bluffed it, like thinking you're weak, then you could have came over the top of him, taken away from him. You got his money. This way you don't get his money.
I understand. I think what happened there was I saw the queen. He didn't bet it, but I've seen him, you know, pull coolers before. I'm folding up this 10-3.
Okay, close your eyes for just a second, Rondster.
Okay.
Everybody close your eyes. Be honest now. They're all closed?
Yep.
Who made it the min raise without looking?
Oh, Duplass.
Wrong. He left a long time ago. Take a look.
Walt.
Okay. You got to know who your opponents are at all times. If someone leaves and somebody else goes in, you got to start the process all over. And if you're not watching what's going on, folks, you're missing out on a lot.
Right, exactly. So I missed that.
Yep. Wow. Just like no jokers just came in down the bottom.
Yep, he did. I see him there. So now we have to take him into consideration because Hot Dog is gone.
Hot Dog is gone. So again, these are all things, these are all edges. We're covering edges today in this session so that everybody understands what a person has in money up here and back here. And when they leave, how they play and who comes in and what, how much they sit with, all those give a person edges. Who you can steal from, who you can't. Who you can bluff, who you can't, who you can see bet, who you can't, when it's time to check and take a free card. All those are edges, and you have to have your game in that top gear to make everything work. Now, he posted, and he won that pot with 10-2.
Interesting.
Because he didn't bet enough to get him out, which means he is not, like you said, a good player. I don't know why you didn't get cards here.
We might have been sitting out.
We sat out for one, and then we sat back in. They wouldn't give you the cards because you were on the button. That's the only thing I don't like about the software. Sometimes the clock runs down, and it's right around in this area, and then you make a decision, but there's a delay or something, and then all of a sudden it times you out. You made your decision, but it didn't. So you got to try to do it somewhere right after the dollar sign. Right in here is where I try to make my decisions, is unless I'm doing it fast. Okay, we're going to post the dead money, this is the dime.
I'm going to fold Jack 8 out.
So this one here, I have no problem with him folding it out at all. If he wanted to play it, I'd play that for the dollar raise there. I don't like the double gapped hands like this. If it was Jack 9, definitely I'd be playing it for sure. But the Jack 8, I have no problem throwing that away, but I would never limp with it, folks. Just don't limp with it. And here, because it wasn't, you know, well, it was raised, so, you know, you wouldn't get away with anything here. You'd take the free card, maybe, or you might continuation bet, depending if you had one or two opponents. And, of course, you don't care if the four pairs, you care that it matches this card right here, so you get a four flush at least. This would have been a disaster, so his decision was correct.
Okay, so ace-9, definitely going to be betting it. We have 1, 2, 3, 4 players. I'm betting $1. Not the best hand in the world, but when you're four players, it's...
Well, I was talking to a player the other day, a new player, and he was saying, well, what are you talking about the value increases, Al, when the player's short? Well, I tell you that the value increases. This ace-9 is like ace-jack here, or it's like ace-10 suit. Its value is more because you only have fewer opponents. So it takes on a new face. So don't look at it ace-9. Look at it as something worth a little bit more than ace-9.
Yes.
And for those of you that doubt that, just take a deck of cards at home and deal them up, face up, four-handed, five-handed, and take a look at what kind of cards come out. And ace-9 most of the time is going to be the best hand that you see. It's rare that you see the ace-queen or ace-king or pocket queens when you're doing it four or five handed. He raised.
Yeah, he raised and he called. Now, I'm out of position here, and I love 9-10 of clubs, but I'm not going to play it.
Not going to play it.
I'm not playing it.
Okay. I would be 50-50 on the fence here. I would have probably played this hand for a call. I would not have re-raised from this hand, and I would have checked this flop, letting River Pro bet at it, and then if a club came out on the turn, I would have bet a small amount into him just to get money into the pot and see what he does.
Absolutely. That was a 50-50 situation.
Yeah, but because it was a 9-10 suited, connected, and you got a loose player here, and you were closing the betting, you didn't have to worry about another raise, it was one of those that I would probably lean a little bit more to play.
Okay, I'm going to fold out 8-4 hearts. We got three viewers.
Poker Player BH. I don't know who that is, but you're in the chat and want to tell us, you know, where you're from, or if I know you are of any kind, or a Rondster knows you, let us know. And please click on my name there and follow. I'd appreciate that. Get notices when I'm up. I got over 100 videos up on YouTube. You're welcome to look at. It's all at the low limits. Building a bankroll, so. Right here, I'm shadowing Rondster. He's playing for me because he can't get on the software today. He's making all the decisions.
I'm folding out my 9-5 here.
Okay. Now, it's interesting to see that. I was just going to say, you see all these bets here. Now, this is a guy that would do this with two hands. You know, when he has the big hand like ace of kings, or if he had pocket sixes or sevens, thinking he could steal everything and get all that money.
Yep.
Sometimes they'll show, sometimes he won't.
He does it once in a while. He doesn't do it too often. I would have put him on probably aces or kings, even though he could have sixes or sevens.
Yeah, but that's foolish to do that. He could have done that for $4 and got one of them to call, and he'd been a big favorite. He didn't have to do all of that.
Alright, so 7-6. We're going to hit for a dollar.
This is the same hand earlier that Rondster had, and he was on the button with 7-6. Now he's not on the button, and he folded the 7-6. Uh-oh. Now we got two hands in a row, the same thing.
Yeah, well, he's looking for somebody to make a stupid mistake, and we're not going to do that. We're folding out. No way I'm
so
folding.
We need to know, or everybody needs to know, what is he going to do the next hand? You know, we got an easy hand here, but see if he does it again. See if he's going to continue to do this. Then we know, see, now he didn't. He may have had two hands where he had ace-king or ace-ace or something good, and he did it both, and he wanted people to think, you know, he was just tilting when he really had good hands. We don't know that.
Wow.
That's the one we really want. We want to see flops with pairs.
Yeah, that's for sure.
We don't want to chase people away. What did that guy say there? WT ruined a table pro.
What he's saying is River Pro is ruining the table because he's going all in. Okay, 2-6 were full now.
He left. And no jokers left because of that.
Yeah, he
well, when people do that, just sit back. Just don't call him with ace jack and ace 10. Don't try to be the hero. Wait till you have something really good.
Yeah, we're going to fold this out. I'm not playing against River Pro with 4 or 5.
Right now.
I think he's going to be raising everything in sight. He's going to try to cap in the table for now. That's okay. We'll set the trap for him. I've beaten him many a time playing cash so far, so I've got a pretty good idea of what this guy does. I think one of the things that I have to realize that's a leak in my game is when it's only a small amount of money to call, I should be doing it, you know, to see a flop.
If you've got position or if you've got cards that can flop something really good, but you're taking a chance on it, if it's small enough, yeah, fine. But if you don't, you know, you don't want to waste that or leak that money either. You just got to look at the circumstances and the situation. Oh my goodness.
Ooh.
A backdoor flush.
Oh. All right. 8-9. We got a button. I'm going to fold.
He settled down.
Yeah. Well, that'll settle him down for a little while.
No, I meant he settled down from the all-in stuff.
Yeah.
Unless he, you know, if he starts to do it again, then we know he's on a pattern. He's just, anytime he gets something halfway decent.
I watched him play a lot. I haven't seen him do that many times. He's doing something. He's experimenting or something right now to see what kind of reaction he gets. All right, we got a 50-cent raise. We're out of position, but it's going to cost me, and it's Walt, and it's going to cost me 25 cents. Assuming he, all right, well, we're going to call, see a flop. All right, so the question is, why did he bet 50 cents? Let's assume that he has some high cards, like a king queen, or maybe even an ace jack or something like that. So we're going to put a bet of, we're going to pot it right here. And we're going to see if he's got anything or if he thinks of mine. Yep, there we go.
I would have not potted it. I would have made it a dollar. That's enough to find out exactly what I wanted to find out there. And if he does, only the nine stays. Only the nine stays.
Right. Okay, so we got River Pro. I'm out of position. I'm not calling. No. Well, 15 cents, you know, all right, I was going to say for 15 cents, maybe I should call. I did it again. Sorry. I should have seen a flop for 15 cents. All right, so Jack 3. Yeah, I'm going to fold that too. I just want to get myself in a situation when I go up heads up against River Pro, I want to be in a position that I can take advantage of him, not him taking advantage of me. So I'm a little more cautious than I normally would do because I know we're going to have a big pot sooner or later.
Okay.
But I have my jack. Still a terrible hand, jack three. Ugh. Let's see, Walt is playing back at him, so that was interesting that he checked. Now, River Pro probably won't do anything here. Yeah. Okay, let's see if Walt bets the turn. I think they both may be going for flushes. Let's see if Walt checks, and I think that I may be right on that.
I think most people that are going for flushes usually bet it.
Well, I think a River Pro is going to bet it even if he doesn't have it, which he did do. Now, let's see if Walt missed, he's not calling.
You think River Pro could have 4-2?
I don't think River Pro has anything. He was just looking to out, you know, post play him, and he does that quite a bit. Queen 3, I'm going to fold. I'm a 48, brand new. So we have a brand new player, folks, and we're going to see how he plays and try to get an idea of what range of hands he does and what kind of patterns he'll do. You know, a lot of players out there, when I play live, a lot of players out there don't understand why I play online. They don't understand how you can figure things out. And patterns is a great tool. They just don't understand it. Oh, we got a caller. We got a king 10. Let's raise a pot.
Pot?
But just enough. Just enough because I know he's not going to call. TJ Toler is so weak that if he just calls, and we have a new player, runner double A just came in. And he posted. That's something to keep in mind, guys, because the
No,
post.
no, no, he's blind.
Oh, he is a blind. Okay. So I'm in a small blinds. I'm going to fold. I don't know what this guy does. I don't feel like being getting into any kind of problems. All right.
What were you thinking?
So here, you know, king nine again. We're basically five-handed. I'm on the button. I would say I'm going to raise a dollar.
Different than the king nine you had before, where you were under the gun and you were trying to do something, and I said you were in the reverse tilt mode. I think you've come off of that now. I think you're getting a little bit more selective and you're thinking things out a little clearer, but that was obvious on the button. You can do that. What I like to do in these situations where I have time and I have my cards is think about what am I going to do if this guy limps or if this guy raises or
Well, I'm definitely going to pot it right here.
I would have made it a dollar because I would have stayed consistent with what you were doing.
Okay.
I
Well,
mean,
thank
if you're going to stay on that line, they don't know what you have no matter what you have.
you. Yep.
Now you put in a different bet, it's a little
Suspicious.
suspicious as to, well, why is he only doing this now and he didn't do the dollar? Is it less of less, you know, strength hand or is it more strength hand?
Well, he made a fast check, which could signify anything. We're going to pot it right here, and we're going to see where we are. If he has the ace, he's going to tell us right away, and if he doesn't, he's going to fold. Because then he's going to think we have the ace.
Why would he think you have the ace?
Because we bet heavy on that one.
No, because you raised pre-flop.
And we raised pre-flop. Well, he called, so it's a real problem. I'm gonna check this turn.
I would have fired the turn again.
Let's see if he checks this down or not. A 10 doesn't help me out at all.
He's gonna fire at least 380 here, 390. Nope.
Well, we're gonna check it down.
He's got to be. Nope. He's got a draw. Look at that. He stayed on that flop. Because of his gut shot, 4-5, he had 7-8, he stayed for a 6. Great information.
He fooled us, or in this case me, anyway, I don't know. I mean, I really thought he had the ace.
Yeah.
I'm going to fold that out.
But let's go back to that hand and examine it. You bet the flop, and he called you. The turn came, and you took the free card. You gave him a free shot at his gut shot.
I did, but before that, and you're right, I shouldn't have given him a free shot, but before that, after the flop, I did put the bet in,
and he stayed.
And he stayed, so right. I figured, why else would he stay unless he had an ace? And
well, because now you have to start thinking about other hands that other people have, not just the ace. Don't get yourself focused on just the big card there. Look for possible draws. If it's a rainbow, it's not a flush draw, maybe there's a straight draw, so he had a 7-8.
Yep.
And he did have the draw.
$1 bet. Let's go back to our line.
I hope you folks out there that are watching Rondster today are enjoying the play and the commentary. Please let us know. You can email me at alspath@alspath.com and I'll get any messages that you have for Rondster over to him. Ron loves to hear from people too, and you can also post when I put this up on social media on Facebook or on my YouTube channel, Al Spath, 2 words, where I hope you subscribe free and tell some friends. I'm up over 150 subscribers now. I'm on my way to 200.
We're going to fold that out, Al.
Okay.
That's no value for us at all. So we got a call from runner double A. That's interesting. Check calls the flop, and that. I can't believe that guy
wall checked. Anytime a guy does that and has position that checks, when I get the next card, if it's a nondescript card like that too, or hits the board where it pairs like that, I bet into that guy and take that pot. Because he didn't have any interest before with the two out there. He sure didn't improve with the two.
I just wonder what he had that he won $2.
Pocket tens, pocket jacks, what do you think?
Yeah, I don't know because he didn't bet any of the twos, but maybe he's just
Queen Jack, Queen Ten, Ace Queen.
Yeah, I'm gonna put him. I don't know what I'm gonna put him on. We're not gonna know. Unfortunately, the software here doesn't let us see. That's a shame.
No.
It's the second time he's raised. I just didn't understand his raising and the line he took. He took a crazy line after he raised. I just didn't understand it at all. All right, so I'm going to fold.
Good fold.
Yeah, I don't like the small blind. I don't like being out of position.
Good fold.
I'd rather take win, down, go out when you're out of position. Because I find that I'm making more money, even if I'm wrong sometimes, I'm making more money by staying in position. Queen, four of diamonds. I got three players. And blah, blah, blah. Yeah, I don't like it. I'm folding.
Let's go back and replay that. Let's listen to Rondster, and he said, "Queen four diamonds. I got position. I got three players. Blah 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 blah. That means I'm not really interested in this hand. I'm out of here. If you think, well, should I play this hand or this play hand gets me in trouble, or I don't know if I should play, just fold it, folks. You're gonna get another hand. As it turns out, he got two pair here. He might have got crushed by this guy who had ace four, ace seven, ace queen, or something like that. It looks good when they hit the two pair on the turn, but you don't know what's gonna happen. So he did the right thing. It's not a hand to play.
No, I'm gonna fold queen nine also here.
When in doubt, get out. You're right.
Well, that has been the difference between making money and not making money. When in doubt, get out.
You can't let the money go back to the other players. When you get the money, you've got to protect the money. It's not house money, it's your money.
Sorry, Rez, but I got to fold here.
Sabath, may you rest in peace, Tulio Braz, B-R-A-Z, from Vegas. He has since passed. Uh-oh, Rez is on your case now. And he would always say, people would always say, hey, I'm playing with house money. And he would say, no, it's not. Once you win it, it's your money. And it's not house money. Don't give it back.
Yeah, absolutely right.
Watch the seven come off. Or a four.
Or a four? What I'm interested to see is what Walt shows. I want to see what kind of cards that he goes with. I haven't been able to see that yet.
Oh, he's calling for a quarter. He's calling.
All right. 6-5 versus
seventh. Yeah, he had over a pair of the fours.
Yep. All right. We have queen, ten of hearts suited, but we're way out of position. We got six players, which gives a little better scenario. I'm going to fold.
I would pot that every single time. I would pot it. Not a dollar. I'd go 60 cents right here on this bet. Put the pressure on people. And maybe I'd go a dollar sometimes, but I definitely would not fold this hand. This is the hand that wins the most kind of money here. Remember, I'm telling you, gap suited cards are good hands. Right. Now, that's not a bad flop, but it's a bad flop in the sense that it's three clubs and you got four people that are in here that one of them's got a good club for sure. You know, you don't mind a 9-8 on the board and have the jack for the straight. But you don't lose anything when you fold, so.
That's correct. Well, we'd have picked up a queen. Pair of queens on the hand. Let's see how.
No, yeah, you've got a queen that could have given somebody two pair though. Yeah. That's the thing.
I think that's the most we've ever seen Tuller bet, folks. So you can bet your boots he's got something decent.
He could have the 10 jack. He could have flopped, you know, and turned it, and first he could pair. Have two pair here. He could have the flush and didn't bet till the end.
Okay, here we go. Ace 10 of clubs. Sure.
Flop the nuts. Why would he bet? Absolutely. You can't bet at the end on that board. Too dangerous.
Interesting. It's the most we've ever seen him bet. I mean, he had the nuts. So that tells us a lot as far as he's concerned. Walt so far has been the unknown for me. And yeah. Runner AA, I still haven't seen enough cards from them. Omni 48.
This a fold?
For me, it is.
Okay. We got one, two, three, four hands for the session. We're just over an hour at this time. We'll take the auto post off. Okay. And let's see what you can do in the next four hands.
All right. I'll try to get a little more money in.
Well, even if you don't, you're doing 30 plus. Whoa.
Well, I'm not going to call. And for everybody that's going to wonder why I'm not calling to set mine is because this guy don't bet like that unless he's got aces, so I'm not calling.
Okay, here's the reason you don't set mine, folks. The guy has to have 10 times the amount of the raise to set mine because of the odds that you're going to get your card, okay? He's got to have 10 times that amount. He doesn't have 10 times that amount. Again, I said before, look at the money up front, but look at the money in the back. It was way too much money for the odds for him to do anything. Rondster did the right thing for sure. Even if the guy had $30, it'd still be a very iffy call. I would not do it.
Now he's back to that. So I think what we're going to do here is we're gonna raise it $1.25. He's telling me he's got nothing. I don't know about Skinhead and Walt. Let's see how they react. Oh, there's a big raise. That tells us a lot. So, you know, I'm actually going to check fold. because
you mean raise fold.
Well, yeah, I'm
you didn't
raise
check.
fold. Raise fold. I thought I was dead there when he's showing us that he had a big hand. I'm gonna fold this out.
Okay, next hand is your last hand.
Okay.
And I thank everybody for watching the video. Tell some friends. Al Spath, two words, up at YouTube. Al Spath, one word. You can follow me at Twitch and get live notifications. I thank you all for watching. Rondster's got one more hand. It looks like he's $30.53 to the good at this point, which is a great amount of money. If you think about it, for an hour at a 10-cent, 25-cent table, if you could earn, which is probably unrealistic. Rondster? Ron? Well, we may have had Ron go out, so we'll just fold that for him. But if you could earn $30 for every hour down at the 10 cent 25, you'd be awesome. 5 hours a day, be 150 a day, 5 days a week. You'd have yourself 750 at the end of the week. You'd have yourself about $3,000 a month at 10 cent 25. So it's unrealistic to think you could always take 30 cents, but hell, that's what this training is about, is to get you to where you can try to win that much, and maybe you don't get there, maybe you do, and we hope that you get on the plus side, as Rondster has proven again today. Thank you, Rondster, for your time. Thank you, everybody, for listening.
Thank you, everybody.
Okay, see you later. We'll do it again real soon.
Okay.